I'm going to start recording. I will upload after this session, okay, on our YouTube channel, and you can verify on YouTube channel. We have a F5 session videos. We have MPLS classes video. So you can. If we get disconnected, like due to internet, so allow us. Yes, Pulkit, no problem. I will, you know, actually I want to lock right now. Okay, after 15 minutes I will unlock. Okay. Yes. Okay, now so how many of you guys are very well aware about, you know, I think you are coming from, you know, routing and switching. So maybe you are you have some little bit of idea about network security. How many of you know very well about what is firewall exactly? Can anyone? Imran, this is not F5 class. Okay, Monday is F5 class, so you can ask this question, Imran, to Neeta sir. Okay, Imran.
Sir, I'm talking about the F5, not F5 lab, but the Palo Alto lab, sir.
But I didn't said anything about Palo Alto, how to upload, how to things. So it's a first day topic, yeah? Okay?
Okay. I think we have a session before as well.
No, the session is F5 already running, okay?
Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Turn off your mic. Okay. So without wasting any time, I hope you guys are very well aware about the firewall. So let's start the session today. What topic I am going to cover here? So please. So this is the book which I'm going to cover here. Firewall 8.1 is the book code is what? EDU210. So this is the book code which I'm going to cover. And this book is coming in the session of PCNSE. Okay. This is the book code. This is a book code for EDU210. And what the topic which I'm going to cover here. So guys, you can see in our module, we have a 16 module in EDU210. And you can see the target audience for Palo Alto session is what? The target audience is a security engineer, security administrator, security operation specialist, security analysis, network engineer, and support staff. And you know, you guys need to know, or maybe you guys are very well familiar with the networking concept like routing, switching, IP addressing. You guys are some have idea about IPS, proxy, and content filtering. Do you guys have any idea about these topics? What is proxy? What is IPS? What is content filtering? Please type on chat window, please. Okay, so I will, you know, I will figure out. If you have no idea, so I will discuss everything. No problem. Okay. Yes, you have to. Yes, good. You know, right now there are 65 students right now in this online session. So you have to, you know, say yes or no. Good. So guys, this is the book exactly which I'm. Yes, Intrusion Prevention System for IPS. Now please, this is the section which I'm going to discuss here. The first topic in Palo Alto is called Next Generation Security Platform. It's very important because, you know, if I'm working with firewall like Palo Alto, Checkpoint, and, you know, FortiGate, Sophos, Cisco, ASA. So what is next generation platform? Because Palo Alto introduced first time, introduces next generation firewall. So what is the next generation firewall architecture? Because, you know, Palo Alto follow what? SP3 architecture. What is SP3 architecture? I will tell you in class, no problem. But you know, next generation security platform and architecture is different. What kind of hardware we are using, you know, what kind of hardware we are using in Palo Alto session, in Palo Alto, and you know, what is the capacity if I'm working in a simple organization, in a medium size of organization, so what kind of hardware I required. The next module is called virtual and cloud deployment. So how to deploy our Palo Alto VSD on, you know, on virtual. And the next thing, what initial configuration. Initial configuration means how to configure interfaces, what is the packet flow of Palo Alto firewall box, and how to get a management, how to get update in Palo Alto. The basic commands, this is the initial configuration of Palo Alto. The next is interface configuration. Guys, remember always, we know only things what we have, we know very well about L2 interfaces and L3 interfaces. But you know, in Palo Alto, we have what? We have TAP interface. We have TAP interface. We have HA interface. We have L2 interface. We have L3 interface. Yes, we have. Okay. So what kind of interfaces we have right now? We have a virtual wire interface. So we have multiple interfaces, how to configure interface, how to configure inside, how to configure outside. This is the interface configuration. Okay. Clear, guys? So module number 4 is called, we are going to discuss about interface configuration. The next is what? It's very important for you. And in module number 5, we have two topics, security policy and NAT policy. So we have two topics. First is called security policy and second topic we have what? NAT policy. So module 5, in module 5, we will discuss how to send the traffic through the firewall, how to define security policy, what traffic I can allow, and how to configure NAT. You know, in Palo Alto, we can configure static, dynamic, static path, source, and destination-based NAT. So yes, we can in Palo Alto. And the next is, why Palo Alto is called next-generation firewall? So now we are going to discuss about the features, the important features. Okay, why Palo Alto is called next-generation firewall? Because of App ID. So the good thing about Palo Alto firewall is what? You can filter your traffic behalf of your application. Like if you want to block torrent, if you want to block Facebook chat only, not only application. If you want to block, you can also block micro application. Like if I want to block, you know, Facebook, okay? Or if I do not want to block Facebook, but I want to block Facebook chat, Facebook video, Facebook gaming. If I want to block, yes, I can block micro application. So how App ID will work, we will discuss in module number 6. The next and very important is called Content ID. You know, guys, only this topic will take 3 hours. Okay. One person want to allow. Yes, sure. Okay. Send a request. So I will add. No problem. Okay. The Pancho. So, you know, guys, Content ID, we will discuss here. Content ID. Wait, guys, I need to add some more students. And now, please, I'm going to log the meeting. Okay, so please, you know, it's going to disturb our session. Okay, guys. Please turn off your mic, everyone. Okay, good. So now we will discuss about the Content ID. So what is Content ID? In Content ID, we will discuss about the antivirus signature. We will discuss about vulnerability protection. Okay, wildfire analysis. Okay, spyware, malware. So lots of things we can discuss Content ID, and only Content ID will take 3 hours. Only this session will take 3 hours. Then in Palo Alto, yes, in Palo Alto, you can do URL filtering. You know, in Palo Alto database, they have a what? They have a category of, you know, websites. So you can filter the, you know, websites behalf of the categories. Like if I want to block social media, websites, so I can define in URL filtering. So for in Palo Alto, you can also do URL filtering. The next is what? Decryption. So the good thing about Palo Alto, if any traffic is going through the Palo Alto box, see. If I have a Palo Alto box and I have a switch and there are some computers connected in my LAN and this is my ISP connection. So any traffic is going through the firewall. If traffic is HTTPS, so no problem. I know this traffic is encrypted. But you know, if I want to decrypt the traffic and if I want to see the content of the traffic, yes, I can. The topic is what? Decryption. With decryption, Palo Alto has a capability to decrypt the packet and, you know, decrypt the traffic and see what content is going through the session. And behalf of the session, you can allow or deny. Okay. So the good thing about is called, yes, banking sectors is also using Imran, that the, decryption policy. So decryption we can discuss in Palo Alto session module number 5. And the next is module number 10, that is called wildfire analysis. It's a separate session. In wildfire analysis, I will discuss about Bright Cloud, or you can say Palo Alto Cloud. So what is Palo Alto Cloud? You know, I will discuss in session. And you know, in not only with IP address, but you can also filter your traffic with user ID. What is user ID? You know, if I have a Palo Alto box firewall in my trusted network, or you can say in my LAN network, I have a computers. You know, if this has IP address 192.168.10.1 and trying to open what? Facebook. It's trying to open Facebook. And you know, a user is coming here, and user one is trying to open Facebook. After some time, second user is coming, user number two, and is trying to open torrent, but he is sitting on same IP address with on 192.168.10.1. You know, so for an administrator, for a security administrator, it's very difficult to, you know, verify who is trying to access BitTorrent because the IP is same. So I can filter our traffic with user ID. I can define my policy behalf of the user account. Okay, understood the topic concept, everyone? If you have any problem, you can ask question. Is it good what I'm discussing here? Please type on yes on chat window if you understand anything. Good. Yes, please. Okay, good. So now the next is what? Global Protect. I know very well, all the students are very well aware about SSL VPN. Maybe some students are coming from Cisco background, so they know very well about, we have a two type of VPN, IPsec VPN. We have remote access VPN. In remote access VPN, we have SSL VPN. And yes, in Palo Alto, we have a topic for SSL VPN is called Global Protect. Yes, so for SSL VPN, I will discuss about the Global Protect topic. And yes, also we have site-to-site VPN, which is related with IPsec VPN. So yes, we can connect multiple sites. If we have a two site, like we have a two site, we have a Palo Alto box and we have a ISP connection. And on another branch, we have a Palo Alto box too. And if I want to create a secure connection in between both sites, so I need to create site-to-site VPN. Okay, so how to configure site-to-site VPN on Palo Alto box? Yes, we have a topic. The next is, after everything, you know, if you configure app ID, contained ID, URL filtering, decryption, wildfire, user ID, global protect, site-to-site, everything configuration, you now the time is you need to monitor and report the traffic. Okay. The monitoring and report the traffic is what? Everything I configured very well. What is happening in my network? Well, I want to monitor the traffic. I want to make a report. I want to create an inventory. So this is the topic for module number 14. Okay. Understood? Global Protect. Yes, I can discuss again. You know, Global Protect is exactly called SSL VPN. Okay. SSL VPN topic. Do you have any idea about SSL VPN, Rohan? Yes, exactly. The SSL VPN is a concept is what? Global Protect in Palo Alto. Okay. Now, are we going to discuss context? Imran, context is a topic of Cisco ASA firewall. In Palo Alto, we do not have context concept. Okay, Imran? Okay, good. Now, the next is what? High availability. You know, if I'm working in organizations and I have a single Palo Alto box and all my traffic, I have a switch, I have a computers, all my traffic, I have an ISP connection and all my traffic is going through my single firewall box. And this single firewall box, if goes down, then this single firewall box will goes down, then what will happen? You will miss the communication between trusted network and untrusted network, inside to outside. That's why we have a concept in Palo Alto box. We can create high availability. So we have a two firewall box, Palo Alto box one and Palo Alto box two. And you know, we have a connection like this, and we have a heartbeat in between both Palo Alto box. And yes, that is called redundancy, Vikas. That is called active passive high availability. What? In this case, the one box, it will act as an active and the second box will act as a passive. So all the traffic will go through the active box, and if the active box goes down, then the traffic will automatically reflect on passive, because the passive will act as now active. Yes, similar kind of you can say a failover. Yes, in Cisco ASA. Yes, it is not mandatory decryption features for all traffic. Yes, Deepak, you can create a policy. What kind of traffic you want to decrypt? What kind of traffic you want to? Okay, it's up to you. You can create a security policy, Deepak. Okay. Yes. So guys, this is the topic exactly which we are going to discuss about. Okay. Now let's discuss about the story behind the firewall. So you know, guys, we had a company. It's called NetScreen. You know, NetScreen was a company. NetScreen technology, and you know, every vendor, you can see everyone, the CEO or you know the key people about the NetScreen is what Kingsley and Nirjuk. So you can see they all are coming from NetScreen. And now NetScreen was an American technology company that was acquired by Juniper. But you know, see, now you can see Ken is now has a own company. It's called, I think you guys are some very well aware about Fortinet firewall, right? So now Fortinet is what? The two brother company. They are coming from NetScreen technology. You can see. Okay. In India, we can say सब एक ही थाली के चट्टे बट्टे हैं, okay? Now, yes. Now you can see Palo Alto. You can see Palo Alto is what for Nirjuk, and for Juniper, yes, we have. And guys, remember always the architecture, the same of Juniper and Palo Alto. Okay, if you learn about you know Palo Alto. So you are very well aware about Juniper firewall configuration, okay? You can say architecture because the both are using same architecture, Palo Alto and Juniper. So now let's discuss about who is the best. So guys, can you have any idea about Gartner report for firewall technology? Yes. So guys, see, this is the report of September 2019, okay? And you can see Gartner reports. So we have a leader right now in market, leader, and we have a challengers, we have a nice player, we have visionaries. So for leaders right now, we have a Palo Alto is a leader, Fortinet is also, Cisco. Why Cisco is leader? If you check 2018 Gartner report, so Cisco is here, is challenger, is not as a part of leader. But you know, now in 2019, Cisco is in a leader. Why? Can anyone have any idea about why Cisco now is leader? Yes, that's great, Shashank. Yes, because of firepower threat defense. Yes, Cisco now come up with next generation firewall. It's called firepower threat defense. Karthik, no, Karthik, no firepower only. Firepower threat defense. Okay, you know, firepower is a different device. Firepower is a separate device. It's a NGIPS. Okay, yes, and firepower threat defense is a different devices. Remember always. So firepower threat defense. That's why this is called next generation firewall. That's why Cisco now in a leader. Now we also have a challengers, but right now you can see the great firewall we have Palo Alto. We have a 14.8, we have a Checkpoint, and we have a Cisco. Now, guys, let's discuss about what is the first question is what? What is firewall? So I'm giving you guys 2 minutes. So please, discuss about a firewall. Can anyone tell me? Please type on chat window. What is firewall? Anyone, any idea? If you want to unmute mic, you can, no problem. Anyone? What is firewall? Anyone? Just try.
So firewall is a kind of security devices which is used to deny or allow the packets that
Yes.
Yeah, we can filter traffic as per our requirement.
Okay, good. Achha. And anyone? Anyone else? No?
To filter out application-based traffic.
So offer deep level inspection.
Yes, we can allow deep packet inspection. Yes. Okay, now let's discuss. Now please turn off your mic. Okay. Here I'm going to discuss here. So what is firewall exactly? Firewall is a system or group of system that manage access between two or more network. What is two or more network? Guys, we have a trusted network. We have untrusted network. See, I have a router. I have a switch. And with switch, I have connected my all LAN computers. And with router, I have connected through my ISP. So you guys can say this is my trusted network, or you can say my inside network, or you can say it's my LAN network. So here I'm going to tell what? This is my inside network. And this is my what? Outside, or you can say untrusted network. So I can manage the access between two or more network. I can allow the traffic. Traffic is going to inside to outside. Yes, allow. Outside to inside. No, not allowed. So I can manage the access between two or more network. That is called firewall. And you know, firewall is what? It's the same like a router. If you want to do routing, yes, you can. If you want to implement NAT, yes, you can. If you want to implement ACL, yes, you can. So firewall is exactly what? It's a router. But it has some advanced features, okay? It has some advanced features. So let's discuss about what technique a firewall will use. What technique? So we have a four technique. The first is called packet filtering. Second is proxy server, or someone can say application gateway firewall. So if someone asking you what is a plane, please explain application gateway firewall. So he's asking for proxy server. The next is what? Stateful firewall, transparent firewall. Thus we have. Now see, what is packet filtering? What is packet filtering firewall? So I think you guys are coming from routing and switching. So you guys are very well aware about access control list, a packet filtering firewall technique. So in packet filtering firewall, we can filter using access list. Yes, we can use standard, extended, named access list, time-based access list, dynamic access list, flexible access list. We have a lots of ACL that is called packet filtering technique. Okay. The good thing about the packet filtering technique is what is advantage is easy to implement. Cost effective. Disadvantage is what? If I want to permit or deny multiple traffic, if I'm working in a big organization, so, creating lots of ACL, it's very hard to create and maintain. So the disadvantage, not a scalable solution, and complex ACL are hard to create and maintain. Okay, the next technique firewall will use is what? Proxy server. So what is proxy server, guys? Proxy server will act as an intermediate system. See, I'm going to explain you what is a proxy server, Pete. So what is proxy server? See, I have a router and I have a switch and I have computers. Now, I have a proxy server in your network. With proxy server, I can permit and deny the traffic, what traffic I want to allow or deny. Okay. So the proxy server is called, I have a proxy server and here I just deny, allow LinkedIn, Facebook. I have just done a lots of configuration here. I just allow some traffic. I deny some traffic. So what is the IP address I'm using in my network for proxy server? 192.168.10.10. Let's take an example. In my LAN, I have a computer 192.168.10.1, 10.2, 10.3, 10.4, 10.5. See. If I want to my traffic to allow to go through with my proxy server. So what I can do, I need to go on my browser, I need to open my browser. and I need to go internet option, and in connection LAN setting I need to define my proxy setting. So I will define my IP address of proxy server 10.10 I'm using, and port 80 or 443 up to you. So I need to do this configuration. So any traffic will, if any traffic want to go through the proxy server, so I need to define here. Now wait, now see, this is the legacy method. If I'm going on this PC, and you know, if I'm going to open my browser and I'm going to set my proxy setting, so you know, if I have if I'm working with 200 computers, so it's a very difficult to, you know, go each and every devices and define a proxy setting in their browser. If someone using multiple browser, then we will face problem, right? Now the problem is, if I'm working in a big organization, guys, so what I will face problem, you know, I need to go each and every devices and configure statically. It's very difficult. That's why we have a option is called transparent redirection method, or you can say transparent proxy. Okay, someone ask you a question, please explain transparent proxy. So here I'm going to discuss about transparent redirection method. So what is transparent redirection method? Every administrator using right now, you have a proxy server in your network. Now you know, I need to create a relationship in between this gateway and proxy server. Why? You know, on every devices you have a default gateway. Let's take example, the IP address here I'm using on this gateway is 254. So everyone has a IP address of gateway. See, if you can see in my, see, I have a IP address with my gateway information, right? I have IP address with gateway information, right? So you know, if I'm going to trying to access my traffic, wait, my traffic, then traffic going to hit this gateway. Now I need to create a relationship between this gateway and proxy server, because any traffic is going through with this gateway is maybe HTTP or HTTPS. So traffic is going to hit on this gateway. So I'm going to create a relationship in between this gateway and this proxy server. And for create a relationship, we need to use a protocol that is called WCCP. Web Cache Communication Protocol. With WCCP, you can create a relationship. Now, if any traffic is going to hit on the gateway, the traffic is HTTP or HTTPS, the traffic will go to redirect with this, on this proxy server. Then proxy server will verify the traffic is allow or deny. Then he will go to outside. Understood the transparent redirection method? Now I do not required to configure proxy setting on each and every devices. Understood, guys? What is the transparent redirection method? Please type on chat window.
So if we are configuring the like manual proxy, I mean to say, like in a proxy tab, we are entering our proxy server along with the port number. So in that case, we are not using a transparent TR method, right?
Yes, we are. Yes, and TR method, every traffic is going to hit this gateway. Okay, dear. Then the traffic will redirect on proxy server. Okay, I do not. Okay. I do not require to go on each and every devices. You know, dear. Maybe this PC is using 3 browsers: Mozilla, Google Chrome, and you know, Internet Explorer. Then, right? That is the problem. Clear everything?
Clear.
Nice. Clear.
Yeah.
Yes. Same as WSA. Yes. 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 Please type on chat window. Yes, if you understand, so we can move on next topic. Okay. Good. So now. Please, proxy server support FTP server. Proxy is only will act, Deepak, will act as an intermediate system. You know, only intermediate system. If you want to allow traffic, if you want to deny traffic, what kind of traffic? You know, if you want to allow websites, if you want to deny micro applications, why micro websites? Yes, you can, Deepak. Okay. Now, the proxy server is only an intermediate system between inside and outside world. It does not allow inside user to go outside directly. But you know, guys, the problem with proxy server is what? Single point of failure. If this proxy server goes down, then there is no communication in between inside and outside. So single point of failure. So that's why you need to have a backup. And it introduces delay. Okay, because every traffic is if you have a valid traffic, it will check on proxy server. If you have denied traffic, you need to check on proxy server. So it introduces delay. So now a firewall have two techniques. Now we have done what? Packet filtering. We have done what? Proxy server. Okay, the next move on stateful firewall. What is stateful firewall? You know, router is a stateless device and firewall is a stateful device. So what is stateful means? Yes, Nikhil, have you any question here?
You said something about delay. Can you just go back to that point?
Sorry.
You said something about delay, correct? It introduces delay.
Yes, introduce delay, because dear, every traffic is going through the proxy server, right? If it is a valid traffic, I have a router, I have a switch, a traffic is going to hit. If traffic is valid, again is going to check on. If traffic is allowed, traffic is allowed. Facebook, I'm going to allow. If traffic is going to hit, again going to check on proxy. Okay. So okay. If traffic is allowed or denied, doesn't matter. Every traffic is going to check on proxy server. That's proxy why server. It introduced delay. Understood?
Oh, got it. Thank you.
Okay. The next is what? A stateful firewall. Yes.
Anyone? Why all the packets are directed towards router? Why not directed to the main server? The proxy server, proxy what we have. Yeah.
Yes. You know, dear.
Actually, what you showed now is the packet will go to the router and then it will be redirected to the proxy server.
Yes.
So in that case, what is happening is packet is going to the router. That link is also being utilized. And then what I was thinking directly, can the PC send it to request to the proxy server and from proxy server?
Yes, PC can send. No problem. PC can send directly traffic to proxy server.
While here, Smita.